नमस्ते एवरीवन, सौरभ ओवा हियर। देर वर फ्यू यू नो क्वेरीज रिगार्डिंग माय व्यूअर्स एज वेल एज माय फ्यू कलीग्स दैट दे जस्ट वांटेड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ कैन यू कंपेयर द 1991 इकोनॉमिक रिफॉर्म्स विद द करंट रिफॉर्म्स बाय द मोदी गवर्नमेंट। सो आई वुड नॉट लाइक टू कंपेयर बोथ ऑफ देम बिकॉज दैट वन वॉज फ्रीइंग अप द इकोनॉमी एंड दिस वन इज एक्चुअली रिलेटेड टू कोविड-19 क्राइसिस। बट या I'll make you understand what exactly 1991 reforms were, and I will also give some of my views that which the government can take into consideration for reviving the economy. So, just I want to make you understand that what 1991 economic reforms were. In extremely brief, I will give my some points to you so that you will be able to understand that what Dr. Manmohan Singh what he did. So 1991 reforms were to free up the product market. So it was like free up the product, okay, do business, produce and trade, okay, simplification of the entire process that a company goes through, okay. Because previously, before 1991, there were licenses for each and everything that was required. And the licenses were into the hands of few corporate houses. So the small traders or the small manufacturers, they were not able to do the business freely. Okay, they had to generate their product and they have to sell the product via some corporate house who were having the license of selling that particular product. So getting rid of licensing, that was the most important feature of the 1991 economic reforms. And that helped India generate inbound products and also trade it. Import the raw materials, because there were the process of importing the raw materials was also very much simplified for the normal traders. That was the 1991 reforms. Plus the exchange rate, which were going, there was some other rate in the white market and other rate in the black market, that came under the control of a single exchange where you were able to get the particular rate of that particular commodity. So these two factors were the most important. One the exchange, another one is the freeing up the product market. Plus obviously the listing of stocks and etc. Then bringing IT in India, that were also very much. But I'm talking about the basic points. That what was 1991 reforms and how a normal person now can start their business and even do the trading across various countries in the world. So that helped our Indian economy to do business, to create demand and subsequently streamline the supply. I would like now to give some of my views to the Indian government. These are basically my views, and I know actually there are many economists that have their own viewpoints. These are just actually views that a finance person in me has just thought of. So please take a note of it, and you can share your views as well. So high growth, if you want a high growth, if you want to free up an economy, liberate an economy, there are three factors, that is the land, labor and the capital. This all should be mobile. Okay, so freeing up the factor market, okay, these all come under the factor market. So freeing up the factor market was not done in 1991 economic reforms. Okay, for doing that, okay, you need to handle the population of India, and plus you have to compensate the losses because you are using the land. Okay, and you are freeing up the land. But for that, actually, this is not a measure that can be taken in a day. This can take years. But at least this thing should be started, what I think. liquidity support and the credit guarantee the government is already taken that into consideration. I really appreciate it. Tax reform, tax policy, and tax administration. You need to do some extremely important, you have to undertake some measures for the tax reform. It's very important at this time. See, cut the tax, put the money into the hands of people. Okay. In this way, you can generate the demand. Even if you start the manufacturing industry, even if you start the service industry, etc., you will have to generate the demand. And when will this demand get generated? It will get generated when the consumer has that amount of money in his hands, in his or her hands. So by cutting the taxes, okay, you will give more money in the hands of the consumer, and then they are going to generate the demand. So now there will be few economists who are of the views that you need to get the tax revenue. Very important. It's very important. I really agree. But generating tax revenue and utilizing it for infusing it into the Indian economy accordingly, that takes time. In this COVID-19 crisis, you need to generate demand at a very fast pace. So tax reforms that is pending from the Indian government, I hope there will be some steps taken by the government. Another thing is the investment from 2011 to 2012 year. This all, retrospective tax, bill have been started. Because of that, the investment has dropped drastically. Okay. So, then need to be some reforms for the corporate tax, and also there should be some avenues where the investment, the FDI, that can be freed up. So government has taken various measures for FDI, and there should be lesser taxes, the taxation relief for the FDI, the foreign investments. That's very much required in these times, because the investment in India has drastically dropped from the year 2011. It has to be improved. I hope actually the finance minister or the PMO has taken this into the consideration already. So coming up to the point, the fiscal stimulus, the fiscal stimulus that you have to, provide for boosting this economy. For that, you can also cut the GST rate. Because you are a normal trader, okay, a normal trader or a normal service, industry or manufacturer. As soon as they raise invoice, they have to pay the GST upfront. Okay, so if you give them relief in the GST at this moment of time, okay, so that will have more money in their hands and they can use that money for, streamlining the supply. And subsequently, if you provide the tax reforms for the salaried employees as well, and they have more money in their hands, so the demand and supply can be balanced and be able to run the economy and generate the revenue at what. So these are quite a few steps that you can definitely take into the consideration. But these are just a few understandings from my side. And another point is a very important point that will be coming in my next session. That is the agriculture reforms that the Indian government has undertaken, especially the last 3 points out of that 11. The last 3 points have excited me a lot. So please see my next video and you will understand that what exactly the impact is going to be for the farmers and the end consumer because of this tremendous and brave attempt in agriculture reforms by the Indian government. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.